President, the thing is serious. The LRA wants peace. Uganda, the government of Uganda, must tell us its position there. Because both of you are fighting in our land. UPDF is in our land. We did not bring the UPDF to southern Sudan. It was the previous government. You were supported by the previous government. So we say, both of you, if you want to fight, out. But if you want us to help you, it must be said clearly. So this is our message.
For me, I'm very happy to see you today. And I pray, I thank Allah very much to give me time or to give me exactly the day to talk to the whole people of the leader of Sudanese or the Southern Sudan government. I want you to understand clear, or I want you to know well. In our mind or in our movement, SPLA or Sudanese is not our enemy. This is what you should mark very clear in your mind, that SPLA is not our enemies. SPLA is our brothers. We the Uganda, if I go back historically, we come from Sudan. My granddad is come from Sudan, not from any place apart from Sudan. So SPLA is not our enemy. We are not, our aim is not to fight SPLA government. But we don't know why SPLA are fighting us. And since I come to Sudan, we did not plan to go and attack SPLA garrison or detaches. But I know very well that the confusion among us, which is making us fighting or which is breaking, destroying love and peace among us is only Uganda government. Because Uganda government is supporting SPLA. Arab that time was supporting what? LRA. So between that cases, it make a very big conflict among us. But our interest is not to fight SPLA. We just pass from here or from Sudan to go and get our sister or to go and do what we like, but not to come and fight Sudanese people. This is what you want. And me myself, I will talk straight away to you that I want peace. That is why I was in the bush. I want peace. I'm fighting for peace. And I heard in the radio you say that you are going to try and release your level best to see that peace is in the northern Uganda and Uganda is in southern Sudan. I'm agree of that. That is why I was here. I'm agree of what you are saying. And me, I know very well that most of people, they don't know me. They don't know who is Kony. They don't know even my political agenda. Because I was in the bush, I'm a rebel. And Museveni is a government. So you know very well that Museveni is working with very many means. Very, 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 very many ways to find me. Propaganda, what. They did many things. So to get me or to know the detail which is happening in LRA government is very difficult. So if you see now, where do I come from? I come from a very far distance. If you are not serious, and if I'm not serious also, I cannot meet you, and you cannot meet me also. But only that you are serious, and you are not happy about what is happening in Southern Sudan. Because we are all brothers, we are all Christians, we are all blacks, we are all Africans. That is why I'm also talking to you. So I want you to know very well that we, the LRA, we want peace, and we agree for what you are going to say to us. We agree of it. We don't want to fight. We don't want to change fire with SPLA. We want to talk with Museveni government also. But only that, Museveni did not want to talk with us. If you go to Uganda and you ask our peace talk which passed long ago, you will see that, or you will hear that LRA is the first, Joseph Kony is the first man to call Museveni for peace talk. Not Museveni who called peace talk last time, 1993 and 1994. We are the one who called that things. So, as now I've met you and you have met me, you should know very well that there will be nothing among us. The sign which shows that we are not going to do anything is now I'm present in your in your front. And I'm now talking to you. There will be no any change of fire between our people and your people. This is what you should know very well. And me myself, I know very well that the old people, even the journalists, they don't know me. Because to get me is very difficult. First, Museveni also himself is blocking people not to meet me. So that people will believe that, that propaganda that Kony is a terrorist, Kony is a killer, Kony is a what, but I'm a human being like you. Like me, like you, like that brigadier, like that madam. I'm a human being also. And I'm fighting for the right cause. What is happening in our country there is very bad. That is why we are in the bush. You cannot stay in the bush for 20 years for nothing. You cannot do that. So what is happening there is very bad. And me, my being in Sudan does not mean that I'm a terrorist like Arabs. My being in Sudan does not mean that I'm adopted the whole thing of the whole system of Arab. No, I'm African. I will remain African. I will die African. That is what I want the whole people to know. To know. So, if I read the story of SLA also in Kenya, you went there in Kenya to what? To get friends or to the people of Kenya to get relationship. Between you. You went to Eritrea, you went to Uganda, you went to Ethiopia also. As now we are in Sudan, now we are in Congo. Does not mean that if we are, if you went there to kill the people of Kenya, to kill the people of Eritrea, to kill the people of Ethiopia, no. You went there for something which take you to Ethiopia. So we are here in Sudan or we are here in Congo for the something which is good for our life. That is why we are here. But we are here not to kill the people of Sudan. Only that when we pass, those people will come to fight us. So we have to defend ourselves. We have to defend ourselves. We have to see that our people is also is well. But our intention not to, to fight Sudan government, and we are not ready of it. There's no any gain here to fight the Sudanese government, to kill the people of Sudan. That is one thing which you should know very well. Secondly, me, as a LRA leader, I'm agree of everything because I'm a human being. And I know very well, and some other people also, they know very well that what the government of Uganda is saying is not true, because Museveni is fighting me with his old government. So Museveni cannot say that I'm good, I'm what. He will take a way, or he will check for a way which can kill or can make Kony not to be alive in the world. This is what you should know very well. As now Museveni said that I was accused in X or in ICC, which is not true. I'm not a terrorist. I'm also a rebel. I'm a position, military position, as SPLA, as some other people. I'm position. So if Museveni say like that, it means that the whole opposition leader of Africa, they should also be taken to the ex, which is not true. This is what you should know very well, which I know also. So we talk with the Sudan government. I'm agree. Many people also, they are there in Uganda. They are our witness. We agree. If we talk to Museveni, it will not take 4-3 days. He will come and attack us in the middle like this. He will come and attack us in the middle like this, which is very difficult. And last time,
when you send a message to me, I heard from that man. He said that he was ready to talk with me in the Sudan, but not in Uganda. Why? Because Museveni will spoil the whole thing if we talk in Uganda. So when me, I want you to know very well that, Mr. Seriak, that LRA want talks. LRA, they want peace also. As you want. LRA also, they are fighters who want their war also to be finished, or they want to stop war as you are now, not fighting with Arabs, but in a good way. It's not in a local way as Museveni wants. In a good way. This is what you should know also.
For the purpose of sterilization and population control.
Now, I think you have discussed many things to my advice. Me, myself, I don't have any other words about it. I'm agree of you. But you should get and you should plan together with us how to talk with Museveni. Because me, I know Museveni is a person who did not want the idea of anybody. He's a Ghana man. He talks through Ghana always. And this is what you should know. So, with me, I'm agree of you. It depends on how we are going to plan, how we are going to talk, how we are going to do what. But with my people, I've got now many people in Sudan, in Torit, in Luba, in here, in Nabanga here also. I'm a people good. Because we hear the call from you that you want to talk with me. That is why now we are very many, almost 1,000 something. So, you know, a human being cannot be alive without food. You should also plan for it so that there will be nothing which is happening among us. Seeing you talk to Vincent, I think you did not have anything happen, but in this location. Because we are human beings also. We know law. We know things. We are fighting for peace. We want our people also to be in a good life.
I see all my people.
And we want also to talk as you did it with Adam.
We fight for equality.
But in a good way. Not forgery. Not by force. Not in local way. We want yet to be in international also. But not in the way the people of Uganda say. That one is not good at all. This is what I can say to you, but
stand for love.
Surely we want to talk with SPLA, and now we are talking also with SPLA. So when we completed this one, we want to go ahead with the program which you told me last time. This is what I say to you, but please, for me, I'm agree everything. Because I'm a human being, I want peace also. I want my tribe also to be with good health or good life. This is what you know. And I am waiting for the next program or the next thing which is going to happen after this issue. This is what I
thank you very much. The Vice President of Southern Sudan and the members. I want to add a little on what the chairman of the LRA said to you. Last month he met with you. We discussed on the same issue. You are talking of meeting LRA leader, which is now today, is in front of you. And what I'm going to add a little bit on what he says is this. Mind you there that to get a peace is something very, 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 very difficult. And a peace cannot come within a day or within a year, no. We fought for about 30 years now. How many days do you think we can talk to bring peace? And secondly, today we are talking, but in the past we were fighting with you. What makes us to talk with you today? You have seen the consequences, and we also, we got the consequences. Now, what I would like you, at least, to know, or what I want to say, there should be no hidden agenda of what we are going to talk now. If there is any hidden agenda, you have increases. You have increases very, very, very much the burden. Because one, we are not the enemy of Sudan, as my boss said. Now, what made us to come and fight you today, or the clashing between us today, is not only today. It is the SPLA who start fighting us while we were still in Uganda, while we have never what stepped in the soil of Sudan. You had a big training wing inside Uganda, under the mountain called Kelak in Gul district. You fought us there for several times, until one time we clashed and got a radio call from you. When we came to Sudan in 1995, there was a sign or a name written by the signaller on the radio. When he got those of Martin King, he said, oh, this is my radio, we should bring it back. Said, how did we get this radio? No answer. It was you who started fighting us, helping Museveni from Uganda. Till we entered Sudan, you were still what? Helping Museveni. That was the conflict which has come between us. While we were going to Uganda, through passing where near Kit, your people were shelling us. Till one of our commander got this letter, got what? Cattle. And till made us to come and fight you there. When we were coming to the Congo, we never, never, I repeat, kill or burn a single house of the Sudanese. But what the Sudanese, I don't know, that is now what I don't know, was said in the BBC that we kill people, we burn houses, we do what? But we entered about three times in the ambush of the SPLA until we fought with them, almost twice. Some of our commanders also got wounded in that class. Now today we come to kill everything what has passed, the bygone as well. Let it be bygone. Let us start a new chapter as we started on the 11th last month. And by the good faith, by the good luck, today the LRA chairman is in front of you. I am the vice in front of you. You the vice of the Southern Sudan government. Let us talk from here today and finish the conflict between LRA and the SPLA. Stop it here and let it end today here under this mango tree in Mabanga. Aya, from tomorrow, I wish we open another chapter. This is what I want to add a little bit on top of this one. Thank you very much.
The world needs my love.
Yeah, another person who wants to.
But here, it's been a long journey.
It's been
a long road. Long road. No time to
be happy. I'm going to stay for
you. We got to keep your head up. We got to keep fighting. We got to stay strong. We got to hold on. Hold on.
Today he has come here to celebrate you. This means that we are starting today.
Wepedo sana sana. Mimi nakuja kwako kwa swali yako ambao unauliza. Kwa nini tunakuja kudana kwa nchi yako? Bila roho. Alafu nini nakimbia sina
gani?
Mafundi kutoka pale.
What idea from their train?
Kutoka huku wakati ilikuwa mwaka 1967. Watu yote kutarudi sina Islam. Kitu gani nafanyakana?
In 1997, you all came back to Sudan. By that time, what had happened?
Akuna vitu yoyote, hata gari ya Uganda bado japiga wenyewe.
By that time, you are not even fought by the Ugandan